Today's developments out of the Georgia General Assembly are adding to the pile of answers being demanded from the DA.
Fox 5's Brittany Edney is live outside the Fulton County Courthouse with a look at the controversy surrounding Willis. Brittany?
Courtney, Willis is really being bombarded with attacks against her office on multiple fronts. So we took a complete look at all of the local, state, and federal efforts to either get answers from the DA or see the action is taken against her. Fulton County District Attorney Fani Willis continues to experience fallout from her alleged personal relationship with Special Prosecutor Nathan Wade. On Friday, Representative Charlize Byrd filed an impeachment resolution against Willis.
Yes, I have a big hill to climb.
Byrd acknowledges that even if it would pass the House, a two-thirds majority vote from the Georgia State Senate is required.
One never knows until you push the envelope to try these sorts of things.
Former Fulton County Prosecutor Ash Joshi thinks the articles as written are ridiculous.
The language that's used in there about tyrannical prosecutions, seems to me it's more for political effect.
On top of that, the Georgia Senate is forming a special committee to investigate allegations of misconduct. The same claim Judge Scott McAfee will be ruling on come February 15th in the election interference case. Former DeKalb County DA J. Tom Morgan weighs in.
It certainly is salacious and scandalous, but it is not something legally on its merits that warrants recusal or disqualification.
I don't expect that Judge McAfee will dismiss the case unless the defense is able to present actual evidence that District Attorney Willis did something that is impacting how the facts or the evidence or the law will be presented to a jury.
Regarding how Willis spent funds during her investigation into former President Donald Trump and co-defendants, both Chairman Jim Jordan of the U.S. House Judiciary Committee and Fulton County Commissioner Bob Ellis are demanding answers. But even if Willis was removed somehow from this high-profile case, Morgan says she'd be hard to replace.
Ms. Willis's office is the only one I know that can handle such an expensive prosecution.
And everything that we've outlined, that does not include Willis's involvement in Wade's recent divorce proceedings, where a judge recently put her deposition on hold. In reference to the impeachment resolution, Willis's office declined to comment. Reporting live outside the Fulton County Courthouse, Brittany Edney, Fox 5 News.
All right, Brittany, thanks.